You are the first caller and will be placed on hold until the next caller arrives.
RPD migration అంటే RPD ని ఒక ప్లేస్ నుంచి ఒక సర్వర్కి మూవ్ ఇప్పుడు జనరల్ గా RPD ఎక్కడ ఉంటుంది యాక్చువల్ గా రిపాజిటరీ ఫోల్డర్ మీ దాంట్లో ఉంది దీన్ని రన్ చేయాలన్నప్పుడు ఎక్కడ ఉంటుంది RPD సర్వర్ లో ఉంటుంది మీరు అప్లోడ్ ఇక్కడ వెళ్ళి అప్లోడ్ అన్నప్పుడు యాక్చువల్ గా వాట్ ఈస్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ అంటే వెన్ యూ సెలెక్ట్ బ్రౌజ్ అండ్ సెలెక్ట్ యువర్ ఆర్పిడి అండ్ వెన్ యూ సే యాక్టివేట్ యువర్ ఆర్పిడి విల్ బి మూవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ యువర్ మెషిన్ టు సర్వర్ సో ఇట్ విల్ ప్లేస్ ఇన్ సర్వర్ అండ్ ఇట్ విల్ బి దేర్ ఆన్ ద మీన్ ఇన్ డెవలప్మెంట్ సర్వర్ యువర్ ఆర్పిడి ఇస్ దేర్ నౌ దిస్ ఆర్పిడి యూ వాంట్ టు మూవ్ టు అదర్ సర్వర్ that is called RPD migration if same RPD if you have in your local machine if you have same RPD in your machine you can connect to enterprise manager of the testing server link whatever you do that is so now it is a development test development server here you connect to testing EM so it will open testing here then browse and select what is there in your local machine and upload it will go and upload there it will be keeping your repository in a testing server restart it that is one method but if you don't have a repository in your machine it is there so there are two things you are talking one is server your machine when you uploaded your repository on the server development server so your server your repository is here it is not in your machine so if you want to move this repository from here to here so one option is you can move this server to server or the best option is this is your machine this is your repository bring this repository to your local machine so bring repository to your local machine so it will be in your C drive or D drive so now connect to how to bring you should know so there are two things we are talking here one is always think about everything in your server client concept this is your machine this is server if I am running my machine if I am running my OBI server and uploaded what is happening here so now this is your machine this is the client machine so this is the server when you develop repository where you develop when you are developing a repository where do you develop and save no just RPD developing here that will be there in your this is your desktop so where you will have your repository in your machine only when you administration is a client tool it will be there in it will you will install in your machine and when you develop when you save it will be save in your local machine only C drive or a D drive or anything a whatever you choose let's say a.rpd now when you upload it upload means how do you upload it enterprise manager upload it when you upload what is happening this RPD is going and getting placed in your OBI server in case you are your OBI server is your machine only it will go to this machine only and with the version number BA001 okay but means when I say your machine name is let's say Apple 1 is your machine name So this is, this name is dev. System name is dev, this is Apple One. If I say Apple One and Enterprise Manager, means this machine only, that's what you do here. But generally in your machine in a real time, no server or no software will be installed, means server software. So in your machine, you will never have an Enterprise Manager. But currently what is happening, your machine server, your machine client, so that's why when you upload, this one will be getting copied as a 001 and this is being used by VA server. Now when I give dev EM, let's say in your machine, what I am doing, I am giving dev and that port number. You will open here only, but which server it will open?
Yeah.
This server, it is running here. And when you go to select this RPD and then upload, this repository will be moved to it will open here. So when you upload here, this repository, whatever is there in your machine will be there, but this repository will be moved to this machine and placed here, maybe in whatever directory, let's say C drive. Okay, so this is a real picture. This is your machine. When you develop repository and save, where it will save? In your machine only. You give some name. But if you want to really use that repository, what you do? We'll upload it. So when you upload, what will happen? This repository will go and place on the server where you have connected. So in EM, whatever, which server is nothing but this one. Dev. So now I give dev here. So it will go and place this repository in the dev server. Start it. So this will load and then it will be running here. So when you say dev analytics, when you say dev analytics, okay, means you are opening this one. Now you throw away your machine, you throw away your repository, nothing will happen. Why? Because this is actually the one where it has to be there, it is there, where it has to run, it is there, running and all, everything is there. Now, you have placed here and you have tested and everything is done. So what is the next phase as per the SDLC? So now here, how many things we have here? In development, you have a repository, and in the same way, when you create a report after creating analytics, where your reports will be saved? In this machine, because generally BA server, presentation services, everything will be running on one machine. Of course, you can have different, but let's take worst, very common scenario, same. So your reports also will be there under one folder, catalog folder. That big path is there. Whatever you are given as a folder, that is that I am giving as a catalog folder. So your reports are under this folder in this machine. Your repository is under this machine here. So when you say analytics, you will open these reports here. And when you open repository, automatically it is running, you will get to know what you will be opening that. Now, you developed reports and unit tested, everything is done. So now what is the next phase? Your machine is this machine only. I cannot give two laptops, only one laptop only. Previously everything was done, you have here and you have here. So now, as per SDLC process, what we need next? Testing environment. So you will have a different OBI machine. Your OBI will be running again. Here is running, here is running. So now from here I want to connect and open my reports to pointing to this. So to start, means you have your RPD here, you have your reports here. So what I need to do now, I need to move this to here. So first let's take RPD. How will you migrate RPD from here to here? So this is a Unix, this is a Unix. So now if I want to upload my RPD into this machine, what I need to do here? So this machine name is what? Test. In this machine you give test and then em. So when you say test em, which one will open? This will open here. Machine is same only. So it will be linked to this one. And now when you want to upload, we need a repository. But where is your repository? Here. In case same repository you have in your local machine, your job is done. But you deleted or you don't know that whatever is there is different. So what you are supposed to do? Before going to upload here, so you should have that repository in your machine. If it is there, done. If it is not there, what you have to do? You have to connect from here to this machine using FTP software. FTP software is nothing but a browser based FTP. If you install the software here, you will open your Windows, Unix machine in your machine. You can pick up in a browser how you pick up your folders, pick up this file and download your file to your machine. It's called FTP. You can download in your machine also. If it is already there in your machine, happily you can take it. But in case you want to take this actual one which is there here to your machine, you take it and then put it here. If you have it, ignore it. So then it will come to your machine here. So means you have to FTP your repository to your machine. So now you got your repository onto your machine, but it is not here. So now connect to this machine, Enterprise Manager. So anyway, now it is in your machine. Click on Browse, select this one, upload it. So then it will go to part one is over, means your repository mode. Then the next one is catalog. So now you know how to move, how to now have all my reports in the Unix machine here. I want to move from here to here. So what you can do, we already discussed. Catalog manager, select this path, server, online, offline, whatever it is. It will open them in your machine. Copy, we have seen copy. Open one more catalog in your machine only. Connect here, it will open browser, means your system. First one will be pointing to this, second catalog manager will be pointing to this. So copy and paste it. That is the best option. But in sometimes you want to do in a very basic way, you can also, if you know any Unix command, you can move those files from here to here directly. Command, that command is called scp. But you need some knowledge here, so that's why don't get into that. Use catalog manager only. But RPD I cannot move here because RPD, we have a process to upload a RPD. We have to go to Enterprise Manager and upload, browse your folder, RPD, upload. So that is the process we have. So that's why when you open a browser, when you click on browse, it will show only C drive, D drive of your machine only. So it should be in your machine only. Pick it up and then place it, select it, upload it. It will go and place it over there. So that is the migration. Very important. After development, this is the phase. Okay, RPD development, catalog movement. both you have to know, if even if you are not doing, you should know how he is doing that. But this is the process. Okay, so now coming back to this, I think I don't know how many, I'll just go fast, scan this. So these are all columns, everything which you place here. Okay, so now here from the OBIE 11G onwards, there is a new, so right now I can select one subject area, and the subject area columns I can select. See, wherever you see catalog, that is nothing but your folder where your files are copied. Just for our quick reference, it will show everything here, that's all. Now, in OBIE 11G, from 11G onwards, okay, we have a new feature. We can select columns from multiple subject areas. And that information should be available in the RPD. Okay, so here, if you see, there is a plus button right now disabled. Means right now, once you get into any repository, you will see only columns specific to that subject area only. But in 11, you can also add few more columns from a different subject area also. That is called report across subject areas. But only thing is, you should have common elements or tables or a column from this subject area to this subject area. If you don't have, then, so right now I have only one subject area, so and I cannot add it, and that's why it is disabled. But in case you have a other subject area which is common to this, then you will see that press button enabled. BA sample, you can see that. Yes, original RPD, you see, you get that. So means when you click this, it will ask you another repository subject area. You can select from it. You can join two subject areas from the OBIE 11G onwards. Joining of two subject areas. So now three columns here. I want three more columns from a different subject area. So the plus button will help to pick up them. So that is common only. It's very, you don't need to worry how the internal happens. But if you plus symbol is enabled, go and select other one and then you can get it from there. That is available here. And once you select your columns, so these columns are there. You can, we have seen logical SQL and XML, everything we discussed here. Once you add these columns here, for every column you will have a properties. Okay, one property is a filter. You might have seen filters. How many ways we can create a filter? If you want to apply any filter on any particular column, you can just click on filter button and you will get bottom filter added. Say OK. So by clicking any column, okay, in case you want to add a column to filter directly without adding anything onto here. Okay, so you can just go here and then say here. So when you click this, it will show only whatever columns you have here. But if you want to add a column which is not there here, you can click more columns and select. So you can add a column, brand is not there, but we have added to filter. But if you already have a column here, if you want to apply filter on this column, you can select directly from here, or you can go here and add it and click it. Your filter is nothing but a where condition. So when you are adding a filter, so there are multiple ways. Okay, one way is, let me select here. Okay. First, this is your column name. Here, equivalent to, what is that? So you can either type a direct value, or if you want to choose a list of values, you can select and then. So right now I want to select only one particular year, 2010. Say OK. Or 2009, select it. Then immediately it will become, it will show data only for that particular year only. So this is very basic thing you will be knowing. And whenever you want to edit any filter condition, you come here, click here, and then say edit here. So you can select a column, and what is the condition you want to give to that particular column, you can type here, or you can choose whatever values you want. You can choose here, okay, and simple, done your, okay, this I will remove for now. So this is one way of just adding a column and selecting the value which you want and then placing a filter. It is equivalent to where year equal to 2010. So now I do not have, just for example, right now I have a column. Just assume that I don't have this column here in a report, and I have one column called calendar date. Calendar date. Okay. So this is the report I have. I don't have a year column, but I am asking to show only date for show date only for year. Column selected, and we have given, what is that column we have previously? Year column is there. It will give you year here. When you see this report, it will show you what is the year. So that my question is, show data only for 2010. So it is very easy, where year equal to 2010. But now, just for a moment, assume that we don't have this year column in a report. I don't have that information, but I have only this information, calendar date. And I am asking, show only data for 2010 year. So what you will do? Yeah, so we don't have a year column. Just assume that only we have this column only, calendar date, but I want to see only data for 2010. Means I want to put a filter on this particular column only. So that should only allow to show data only for 2010. So what can you do? Now this is having complete date information, but I want to give a condition for 2010, that is a year. So when I will create a filter, but this time what I am doing, I cannot, if you give 2010, I cannot give, because that is a date column. But when I give a filter, I should give date only, but I want to give year, complete year. So what I am doing right now, you can add a column, you can apply a filter. At the same time, you can also, you can add a column, and for that column, you can also add some derivations. Okay, so now I am not giving filter directly to this column. I can apply some derivation on the column. Okay, and remember, when I am saying the filter, I am not applying derivation on this column. And adding a filter, okay, this is the column, and here you see one derivation formula button, and then here I can apply a filter. So how to get a year value? So here are So now what is that we have now here? We don't have a date right now here. What is that we have? We have a year. So it is converting that to year. Now if you go and see here, it will show only that year. And now I am looking for 2010. So you can add a column. So this completely different. That is still calendar date only. I have taken that column and applied some condition on, applying some derivation on that. after derivation, what you will get? It will get convert to here, and then I'm putting a filter. So you can add a filter directly on a column, or you can take the, you can apply the derivations on that, and then also you can see. So since it is even now I can remove this column also, nothing will happen to this. But the formula is still on the calendar date only. So this is very, very, very important. Okay, mostly you will be doing this kind of derivation. Okay. If it is a directly straightforward company, edit filter, I am looking for these companies. So this is a filter directly on a column. This is a filter on a column derivation. You can do it. Both you can do here. Okay. So this, now what is that you have taken here? If you have a column, when you take a filter, let's say if this is equivalent to, one is department number equal to, so this is a straight column and this is a straight value. Apart from this, what we can do, I can also apply some formulas here on calendar date. Then I can put this condition. So you can take this way or that way. You can apply filter directly on a column, you can apply filter on a derivation. This is important actually, mostly in a real time. So left side you can apply, you can take a column or you can apply some derivation. Coming to the right side, so now so far I have selected one value, you can select two values or you can select three values. Apart from this, right now I am going to select one column here. So this we know what kind of formula we will write it. Then operator, the is equivalent to, not equivalent to, you can use any one of the thing here. And right now I am choosing select equal to, not equal to, whatever you choose. So right now I am choosing a value previously, whatever value is there. But apart from that, what also we can do is, you come down, rather than you typing a value or selecting a value, you can also choose more options. One is presentation variable. So you can use presentation variable value as an input to this. If you have created, or use repository variable as a input. Let's say 2010 I have typed it, but if you have created a repository variable, in that if you have a value 2010, you can use that repository variable here. So just select it and then give your repository variable name. Of course you should have a value for that, so you can also use a repository variable here. So now brand is equivalent to, I am not typing a value, I am using a repository variable A. So it will go and check right now what is the value you have in A. It will take that and then it will replace here. Or you can take presentation variable. You can take session variable. So it is like you have to give your variable name, that's all. It will automatically take whatever is there and supply it to that. Apart from that, here you can also use SQL expression. What is that SQL expression? So right now we have a brand column or any column. So I want to take some output of one SQL and then use it. Say for example, okay, so this is your year column. And we already given some formula here. Okay, then what I am trying to do, I am trying to apply a filter on a year column. And now what I want to do, we know that I can type it 2010. We know that I can take a value from a variable and supply it. But what I want to do, I want to take a current year value and then put that as a filter. Means my requirement is I want to see data only for current year. So how you take current year from a system? Sys date will give you a date, but I want year from that. What you will do? I'll show how you generally you type. Since you already know this, I am directly typing them, but anything if you don't know, let me. So here, how to get current date? This will give you current date. This will not work because I am deleting it. So this is your current date, but how to get the year from this current date? We have a current date, but I want to only year. Year of? So now this is a formula which will give you what is the current year. So now what I want to do, sometimes we may have to use, now one example, we have a left side column, right side value. Left side I have written a derivation and right side I have put a value. And these are the varieties we have seen. One is, here is the real column, I put a value. And here I put a derivation in the left side column and given a value. Third one, what we have seen, here equivalent to variable. Repository variable, session variable, presentation variable, anything you can do. So whatever value is there, it will be applied. Now this time what I am doing, year equal to, this is the value, this is the variable. So this, I want to get this value from a derivation. Whatever derivation it could be. Okay. So example here is, I want to get year of calendar date. See all varieties, left side column value, derivation value, column repository variable, column right side derivation. So now, if what value it will give always, what is the current year. So now if anybody asking, create a report and it should always show what current year data only. So you cannot keep 2014 manually type it, why? Your date will keep changing every day. So you can use year of. This will every time it will give you what is the current date and it will go and give that information here. So this time I am going to place a filter on this year column. I am selecting SQL expression. So what is the expression I am using here? We already have. So all varieties, left side and right side derivations you can write, left side derivations you can write. So depending on, mostly you will be using either first one, last one. That is very easy. We have a column selecting the value, everybody can do. That's not a problem. But important is first one and second one. And if I want to select, if I want to see always current day's data, current year data only. So you don't need to change your report every day. It will take the current day, but you will not get any data because there is no data for you. Because do you have data for 2014? No. That's why you can. On top of that, you can also write derivations here. Let's say now let me try this. 2010 we have data, right? At least I can say 14. Let's say 2000. I previously I did year of system date. What year of system date value? 2014. Oh, but what I have written there? Minus 4 means 2010 only. So here just to show some data, but actually current date and all that is it. So why people will ask you, sometimes people will ask you a question. When I create a report, always I want to see last 2 years data only. All these topics mostly are related to your interview. Mostly the questions will come this way. I want to see only current year data. What is your filter? Year of and that you apply to year. Now I want to see only last 2 years data. Every time when I execute a report, I want to see only last 2 years data. So what should be your condition? Minus 1? Minus 2 or minus 1? Whatever you ask. If you say equivalent to what it will do? So now we are in 2014. If I say 2014 minus 1, what happens? 13. If I ask you, I always want to see 1 year back data. 1 year back means if it is 2014, I want to see data for 2013. So minus 1 equivalent. But if I want to see last 2 years data, now 2014, I want to see 2013 and 14. What should be there? And you can do. Apart from that, you can say and means to current year and minus 1. It will just slightly change it. So now if I make it minus 1, it will become 2013, right? So but I want to see data for 11 and 13 and 14. So answer is there. She said and that will also work. But if you make it slightly, if you say current year greater than or equal to that one. So these are common questions. So mostly your life in reporting is filters only. Because the reporting analysis and expense, because data calculations, everything, everybody, everyone will get directly from a column. But they will give you requirements in the form of the filters only. Mostly you will have your life in filters only. Current year data. Every time when I open a report, I want to see current year data only. I want to see only last 2 years data only. Okay, I have a column, but I want to apply filter. You may write a derivation, the left side or the right side value. So all the varieties you will have here. So in the filter, you will have all these varieties. This is a column value, derivation value, column variables, column right side derivation. Okay, so you can pick up any these kind of things. And lastly, we have seen this formula, example for this. What we have taken this example, just remember one example. What is that I have written here? I have taken a date and put year up. Then these operators anyway, I will come back to this. And value you can type it. But if you cannot get a value every time, if you want a automated value, you can use any one of the option, either variable or SQL expression. SQL expression is a derivation, some calculation, whatever you have written. That also examples you have seen. If you come down, you have an option called, not here actually. Operator is based on results of another analysis. Means, I want to pass a supply a value to this particular column. So now, if you see the flow here, typed column, typed derivation, column, variable, here, this. Then here, another report. Maybe in your SQL language, it is a subquery kind of. I want to get a value as a filter condition to here, but that value I don't want to type. I don't want to take from a variable. I don't want to take it from a expression derivation, but I want to take it from another report. Okay, so that is your report filter based on another report. So now I'm going to create one report. If I select this order date, means in which year your orders are placed. Okay. And from here I am trying to select in every year how many number of orders placed. Something is there. Forget about what is there. But I have some report here. Okay. So in this report, I am putting some condition. What condition I am keeping? Okay, so this report will give me what is the highest year. So now this time what I am doing, we have already have a year column here. For this year, I want to get a filter condition value from a different report. You have a query here. I want to put a condition to the query by taking another query output. What is that actually in SQL? Subquery. So you will have another query. This query output you will keep as a condition here. So here also this is our main report and I have a year column. So get the value from another report. We have some value there. That value I want to use as a condition here. So now this is a report, main report. You have a column here. But what is the condition I am keeping? Take the value from another report. So now I am going to another column. So this is the report we have created previously, selected. Means I am asking go to that report and select the values from there. But when I go to report, of course right now I have only one column, but you may have more than one column. So it is asking, whenever you have this column, use values in column. So what column you want to choose? Right now I have only one, which is one. But if you have two columns, it will ask you which column you want to put as a condition here. So we have only one I have selected. When the value, so now what is the value right now? You can assume here that value is nothing but 2010. So when I execute this report, what value will be there in the column? 2010 only. So this is nothing but here it is 2010 now. But only thing is we are not typing. It will take, it will come from the other report. Tomorrow if that report gives me 2011, so this will become 2011. You don't need to change. Automatically it will change it. So and then when you are have a value, when you are supplying this value as a condition to this column, so whether you want to check not equal to, equal to, or whatever it is. Okay, if you say less than of all, so 2010 is there, so less than to 2010 you will get it. If it is equivalent to 10 only, you will get 2010 only. So like this we will get. So I will select any one, means any value should be there, and you will get the data. Almost all are 2010 only, so that's why you are able to see data. Almost everything is 2010 only. So this way you can take the value of another report column as a, so this is called sometimes subquery, subselect, subreport kind of things, anything, but you have an option to select it. So these are the basic way of filtering. So now I am taking a value from another report that I am supplying as a filter condition here. These are the maximum ways. Apart from this, when you go to operators, so now we have seen everything here. So now I will create a, apart from this, no, what he has done, so many advertisements. I want to see only top revenue details. So this is we have seen operator, value is there, supplying a value, derivations, derivations or without derivations, and selections and based on the other report, these are the varieties. Apart from this, when you go to any column here, when you say filter, this we know all we have seen. Protect filter, it will restrict others to change the values in future. When you place them in the dashboards, it will restrict others to change. Protect means it will help you to change, it will restrict others to change it. Okay, so no technically. So, but apart from this, if you go to operator, mostly these operators are your mathematical, equivalent to, not equivalent to, greater than, less than and all. Okay, but is null, is not null means in case you want to check for a null, not null, use it. And now, apart from this, you have a top and bottom. What is top? Whenever you choose top, it will show you top values, how many top values you want. Let's say here, I will select top two values. Say okay. So, I have selected top on which column? The total revenue. So, it will show you top two values, highest top two revenue values it will show here, and if you want bottom, it will show the bottom values. So this way you can also select the top and then bottom values within that. Okay, the top on this, top on this. This is how maximum you can apply filters here. So when you talk about the filter, there are multiple things. One is derivations here, derivations right side here, and select the value from another variables or so many other things. And getting value from the other report and then using here. So these are all maximum. Apart from this, in case sometimes your report is, your filter conditions are becoming very, very complex. So this also you can convert this to a SQL. So it will be like, say now I want to add 4 or 5 filters. Our filter is becoming, you have written a derivation expression you have seen, right? Okay. In that case, if you try to convert any expression, now this is the, so you can use this. Okay, this is how your derivation, you can go and type. So when this can be useful, say now I have a report and I am trying to create C data for 100 customers. I want to see only 30 customers data. 1, 2, 3. So if you start, if I want to see only 30 customers data or 100 customers data, what should I do now? Filter is equivalent to, so here I need to type them 1, 2, 3 like this I want to type. So now I have a list. If it is continuously, I can tell less than, greater than. But I have some list 1, 200, 31, 46 like this. I have 100 customers numbers. I want to see data only those customers numbers. What should I do now? I need to keep them as a filter, 146, 240, 300. I need to select those numbers here. If it is up to 10 also, no problem. If it is 20, 30, 40 numbers, if I want to type, it takes time. Sometimes I will give 1000 numbers. It's very tough. So what we can do, we can convert this as a SQL. Just for example, so now right now 2 values are selected. Like this, I want 100 numbers to selected. It's very tough. So convert this to SQL. So you don't need to select here. So maybe somebody gave you that 100 numbers list. Okay, take into Notepad, put into one order and separate it by comma and paste here. So that you don't need to select one by one here. So that way, convert this SQL can help you to customize your queries. If your values are very, very big, if your formula is very complex, you can type any here and then you can choose it. The one best example is this. For selecting 100 numbers, 200 numbers. If it is serial order, no problem. I can say customer number less than 500, it will go. But now I don't have 1, 501, 1,20,000, 360, like these numbers are there. So somebody gave you that list. Take it and separate by comma, put it over here. Then you will get your data. So same filter only, but it is a different facility. Okay, so these are all filters you can apply on this top and this. Sometimes, okay, if you go here, you will have an option for this. You have seen this one, and we already know all these are operators just, okay. He is ranked first, okay, last. These are all first, last values, equivalent to top, bottom only. And then you have something called is prompted. What is this is prompted? So normally filter means you are giving what values you are looking. You are giving what is the value you are looking. But is prompted means I want to apply a filter on this column, but right now I don't know what is that value I want to apply. when I'm executing this report, in later from the dashboards I will supply filter value. Means is prompted means when I'm executing a report, during the execution it will ask for or look for what is the value to be supplied here. Generally that will use for prompt, dashboard prompts. Okay, so this anyway you will be learning in a prompt section. So, but overall this is the filter, left side, right side, equivalent to operators, and take a value from other report, and use a presentation session variables, and in case you are complex, it will become complex, you can also make this as a convert. Okay, so this is all about the filters, and then next we'll continue. If you are here, maybe I'll take some break and then continue later. If you are leaving, we'll see tomorrow.